So welcome back. So you've seen my video talking about the stakeholder model and what a stakeholder map looks like and some of the theories that go along with that. Let's talk now about a little bit how enriching stakeholders is beneficial to the firm itself, right? You've got your value-creating enterprise at the center, the corporation at the middle of these complex relationships. And let's talk about, let's say a firm does right by all of their stakeholders. Let's talk about some of the ways that these stakeholders can give back to the corporation. Let's think about the state, right? If you pay your taxes to the government, then you should be getting better infrastructure and services. And infrastructure and services is huge. Better roads, police protection, better legal protections from copyright infringement. That's a good thing to have a strong government looking out for you when you pay your taxes. Employees and management, right? If you pay your salaries and provide jobs, then you should have individuals working for you, contributing their skills, and possibly even get loyalty. If you are good to your suppliers, okay, when you buy their products, then of course you get some sort of return. You get products and services in return. So you give them some of your revenue, you get products and services in return, hopefully higher quality, and you acquire some degree of loyalty. If you're good to the community, the local community, you provide jobs and you get involved in the community, particularly through a social responsibility perspective, you take care of the environment, then you know that the local community will become stronger and you will have higher quality employment, higher quality education available. Customers, right? If you give them high quality products and services, they're more likely to give you more money and also get loyalty from your customers. And then shareholders, right? You give them the dividends, you make sure that the shares go up in price, then they're more likely to invest in your firm and give you money back, right? So the thing I want you to take away from this is that stakeholders all contribute to value creation of the firm, but they expect a share of the value that you create. And so, again, there's this kind of balance of power between the corporation and their stakeholders, which is something that evolves over time. Right now, in the United States at least, shareholders tend to have a little bit more power over corporations, but this could, of course, certainly change. So if you look at strategy not so much from a profit generation perspective, but you look at it from a stakeholder perspective, you can also understand strategy as about modifying the terms of exchange between stakeholders or among stakeholders by doing some of the following things. You could reduce the firm's dependence on the stakeholders, right? You could gain power over the stakeholders. You could increase the dependence of stakeholders, so you're less dependent on them, but they're more dependent on you. You could improve the firm's image and goodwill so that the stakeholders are more likely to appreciate you. Now, these are some examples. So in our next video, our next couple of videos, we're going to talk about segmentation and industry analysis. I think it's a fascinating topic, and I'm sure you're going to enjoy it too. I'll see you then.